Carbon 2456.
व्हाट्स अप गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू द चैनल ट्रैवल विद सीके। सो आज अभी हम आए हैं ई समिट ऑफ आईआईटी बॉम्बे और मेरे साथ एक बहुत ही खास फ्रेंड है। सो ही इज ओम सिंह। सो जैसे मैंने लास्ट रोरी टोम 2.0 या जैसे मैंने लास्ट वीडियो में बताया था कि रोरी टोम के बारे में अभी देखा ही होगा। सो कुछ बताइए आपके बारे में।
तो बेसिकली मैं भी ब्लॉगर हूँ, चित्रेश भी ब्लॉगर है और बेसिकली हम सोशल नेशन के टाइम भी मिले थे लेकिन इतने अच्छे खास दोस्त नहीं थे।
सही बात है।
लेकिन अभी दोस्ती और मस्त जमती है, मतलब एकदम अपना जो केमिस्ट्री है दोस्ती का एकदम बाप हो गया है।
और एक बात बोलूँ, अभी जो आज का इवेंट है, अगर हमको एंट्री मिली तो बहुत ही मज़ा आ जाएगा। तब तक हम आईआईटी बॉम्बे घूम रहे हैं। चलो देखते रहिए आगे का व्लॉग।
This is complicated because he's joining us from Miami, Florida. And what I just realized is you can't see him. So let's make that happen. So we're trying to get a connection from Bombay to Florida. There he is. Excellent.
So during our time, our director, Mr. Kelkar, said that he was very confident that none of us would apply anywhere close to 5% of the total knowledge that we gained, that we that they disseminated to us during our tenure at the IIT. They still covered a very vast array of subjects, he said, because they weren't sure which 5% we would need. On a more serious note, I'd say the biggest thing we actually learned from IIT was how to learn to learn. I would say, if I were to look at the subjects we learned during my time, today we apply almost nothing, maybe a few concepts here and there. But the ability to grab, to pick up a new topic, and to find a way to quickly master it is probably the most critical skill that all of you will be able to learn in a world that's changing so fast. If I were to be totally honest, I'd say I probably learned a lot more from fellow students. I'm always fascinated by how different people look at the same information from a unique perspective and sometimes come up with very simple, elegant solutions. So I would say that the biggest takeaways for me were ability to learn new things quickly and to learn from others, from other sharp minds that have unique ways of solving problems.
जस्ट खाना खा के हो गया हम लोग का और जस्ट चले ही जा रहे हैं वापस अगली मंजिल की तरफ। तो तब तक हम लोग आईआईटी में घूम रहे हैं,
एक्सप्लोर कर रहे हैं बेसिकली
हम चल के एक्सप्लोर कर रहे हैं मोस्ट ऑफ द थिंग।
Overall, when you were young, you had a lot of very big dreams and goals. But as you come into become an engineer, those dreams and goals become more and more mundane. And that happened to me too. So when I when I was in my engineering, I wanted to create all those great things and I wanted to try for the Turing Award and all those things. And by the time I got into my first job working at Microsoft in Redmond, So my goal is like, you know, how do I buy a Ferrari? Okay, now I got a 4800cc vehicle. Now I want to get a Ferrari sometime. So the goals became mundane and this thing, rather than something much more larger, rather than creating something, our goals become on consuming things. 5 years ago, I hardly knew a single person who was a YouTuber full time. But now literally every person I meet wants to be a YouTuber full time or is already a YouTuber full time, right? How do they make their money? Whatever revenue we collect from the advertisers, we share 55% of that revenue back with them, right? So 55-45, very attractive. But why is this even more interesting? What is happening to digital revenues at this point of time? Anybody here who knows what is happening to digital revenues at this point of time? Not like that, yeah. Throw a bigger picture, right? So if you look at the ADEX of a country, which is advertising expenditure of a country, we are at a very, very unique tipping point at this point of time. Just to put into context, 2 years ago was when ADEX in the US saw that tipping point where digital ADEX overtook TV ADEX, which means all the money that TV channels collect together as advertising ceased to be as big as all the money all the digital players were collecting as advertising. In India, digital ADEX is around the 20% number. TV is at about 34 or something like that. But digital ADEX is growing fastest, right? Within that, video is growing even faster. Within that, YouTube is there, right? So everything, as I said, touch wood, is going well at this point of time. So if you just look at where for people to actually, you know, get to that level where they can tap into some of these other revenue streams. So it ain't easy. Ek video bana diya and then it goes viral. I know there was this viral video at IIT Bombay where a cow came into your lecture hall and all that. You can't hope to build a business model on a cow walking into a class. So it takes a lot of hard work. But starting is very easy. Okay? All you need to do is to have a phone, right? Or a camera, right? You might want to actually be a little ahead of the curve and invest in a very interesting simple sound system that costs about $7,000-$8,000, right? That can capture sound better. Right? That's all you need to start creating videos. But before that, obviously have an idea. Right? As I said, don't wait for a cow to walk in. Have an idea. Think about your value proposition. Think about all these content verticals. I have seen that there are three kinds of people who do well on video platforms like YouTube, right? There is what I call the talented person. Who are talented?
Dancers, singers.
Singers, dancers. Anybody here who's a good singer? Okay. The second kind of person is someone who's very passionate about content. Who is a passionate person?
Game, technical
guruji, bloggers, Nisha Madhavika, storytellers, right? The third is what I call a subject matter expert. Obvious, right? People who do learning or people who do technology and all of that, gaming and all of that, right? So I've seen these three kinds of people. If you fit into any of these three buckets, you have an opportunity, right? But think about what you want to do, what you're good at, what you're passionate about, and or what you know the most about before you actually decide to make a video, right? I'm at the end. Thank you so much, right?
So guys, this is it for part 1. सो पार्ट टू में मैं आपको डायनेमो गेमिंग के बारे में बताऊंगा, आशीष चंचलानी वाइन्स एंड इवन सलील जामदार. सो ये दो बड़े बड़े क्रिएटर्स हैं. इसके लिए मैं स्पेशली पार्ट टू अलग से बनाऊंगा कि वीडियो बहुत लंबा बन जाएगा. सो दैट इज़ इट फॉर पार्ट वन. अगर आपको अच्छा लगा हो तो लाइक शेयर और सब्सक्राइब करना भूलना मत. सो एंडिंग द पार्ट वन. बाय बाय. क्या हो गया भाई? चश्मा कैसे टूट गया?
चश्मा टूट गया था.
टूट गया? अरे
गर्दी में हूँ.
होता है
बहुत गर्दी में.
मुंबई इज फेमस फॉर दैट.
तो क्या हैंड्स प्रूफ 100 रुपए का चश्मा
नॉट वर्थ.
नकली होता है.